Today's news, urgent! Pac removed as judges unanimously uphold impeachment.
I would be so remiss if I didn't show this painting, which you just created about a month ago and has already been sold. We're boxing it up as soon as I edit this. What's the name?
Fuji in Spring.
It's so lovely. If you guys are interested, check out all the painting posts that she just created in March. Link in the description. The South Korean Constitutional Court has ruled unanimously to uphold the impeachment of former President Park Geun-hye. Prior to this official announcement being made, I think a lot of people were on the edge of their seat over there. And I think more than anything, what this ruling means is that this weekend is going to be a huge party throughout that entire country. I say that because on my Facebook feed, they're all talking about going to Seoul if they don't live in Seoul. And if they're already in Seoul, they're just asking any Korean that they can, even if they're in a random taxi ride, asking the driver how they feel. I'm also seeing posts about people just celebrating by drinking beer and eating chicken.
If the opportunity calls for beer and chicken chimek, then why not?
There's a very interesting article that we're going to try and cover as much information as possible about linked below. You can click that. It gives a good inside scoop on the types of privileges that she loses. Do you want to go into a little bit more detail about that?
Yes. Well, first I have to say this is the first time in Korea's presidential history that this has actually happened, that they've had an impeachment. But some of the things that she will lose, she lost the presidency. She lost protection against prosecution, which is huge. Very, very huge, because she's got 34 common prosecutors who have cases against her, and now she's just a common criminal and not a president.
She could just be treated like a citizen so they can put her into, that's right,
put her in jail. Oh yeah. She also loses her pension, the opportunity to have 3 secretaries and a chauffeur. She loses the right to free trips to hospitals, maintenance fees for her house, and she only gets 5 years of security.
Instead of 10 years. She loses about $10,000 US per month for the rest of her life. She loses free healthcare for the rest of her life. So it's significant enough. I mean, she has enough money to take care of herself. So these details aren't that big of a deal, but they are interesting. There were protests happening right up until the decision was made for and against Park Geun-hye, the former president. But I think it's important to note that the protests for her being impeached or for the impeachment being upheld were much larger and much more younger focused.
Well, and it was also a lot more and continues to be a lot more peaceful. Those who were protesting saying that she should be out of office. There are currently tens of thousands on Friday night that were in Gwanghwamun Square, which is right in front of the main palace. They were carrying signs and candles. They cheered and swayed to music. And overall, these protests have been very, very peaceful. And some of the largest protests I've heard about in the history of practically the world.
And the percentage of people that were in favor of her being ousted was over 76% of the entire country. That's almost everyone. There's still over 20% that wanted her to stay in power, but I think that this is an example of having a government in place. I mean, all countries have a government, whether we consider them democracies or some other type of government, but this is an example of the process of government working on behalf of the people, in favor for what the people wished to happen.
Yes, and there are people, of course, who did not want her to lose her presidency, and they are not protesting so kindly. And that is also currently going on, where you have a bunch of people who are significantly older protesting. To prepare for this, Seoul in South Korea has put police on high alert. There's over 20,000 police officers who are currently on duty, dispatched, working, trying to keep control over everything. Yep. And thousands have demonstrated, but Park's supporters have been kind of nasty about it. They've hit police officers and reporters. They've climbed on police buses.
They've gotten themselves hurt because police have had to keep secure the areas where they're actually being violent.
Yes, there have been over 30 people injured. They've also smashed windows, and 2 people who were Park supporters have died, one of which was a 70-some-year-old man who had climbed on top of a bus and in the process of getting down had hit his head. To which I have to say, I kind of wonder, why is a 70-year-old man climbing on a bus?
The official public announcement to the nation of the decision to impeach Park Geun-hye was taken very seriously and was delivered very carefully on high alert with security in place, because they knew that there would be reaction one way or another, and they weren't quite sure what that reaction was going
to
be.
There are two more big things that I want to talk about. One being, what's going to happen to Park Geun-hye, and what is going to happen for the future of South Korea and the South Korean presidency. As for Park Geun-hye, we know that she has a house in Seoul, but she's already stated that she's chosen not to reside in Seoul, and she's also not going to live in Daegu, which is her hometown. She's probably going to end up in Gyeonggi province, which is the province that completely surrounds Seoul, and they're speculating that she's probably going to move into Buddhist or Catholic residency for a short period of time, which, if you've ever seen Korean dramas, you know that this happens somewhat frequently when people are trying to hit, like, lay low for a while, or they've been disposed of. You always see it in, like, historical dramas or with big CEOs.
Well, I just think it's important to state that it's sort of like a pressure cooker in that country. I want to talk a little bit about why the government was able to function like it was able to function, whereas it seems like other countries, like, for instance, the United States, is completely out of control, even though we have laws in place. Like, I feel like this sort of thing could never happen in the United States in its current state, but it did happen in South Korea, and it happened successfully. It's totally a pressure cooker in Korea, though, because so many people live on top of each other, so she has no way out. That's the feeling she's sort of going through. Like, I can feel her feelings, not because I'm some special, I just feel like, intuitively, we live there, the longer we were there, and people who live there know if you live there for a long time, I mean, you get used to being on top of each other, I guess, but I don't think it gets easier as time goes by. I think there, if you grew up there and you never really traveled anywhere else, you don't even notice it. It's like being in the Matrix. You don't notice that you're in the Matrix. You just are. You're just going about your business and you don't realize how crowded everything is. I think Park does, and I think that it's going to be very difficult for her to ever feel comfortable ever again if she stays in South Korea, no matter which part she decides to reside in.
Well, considering that tens of thousands of people protested against her, and there are people who are blaming her for the death of their kids and all of these other things that were part of the reason why she got impeached in the first place, yeah, she's got a lot of pressure, and she's kind of trying to lay low because she may end up in jail very, very soon.
You know, people in the world and in society, they really want two things. They want to live a happy life, and they want things to be fair. Fair for them and fair for everybody else. We all have to follow laws. I just can't help but reflect on what's going on in the United States right now. We have a new president. He's more unpopular than he is popular. More than 50% of people didn't vote for him. He lost the popular vote by over 3 million votes. I don't want to make this whole video about Trump. We're near the end of the video, though, and I hope for some sort of fairness in this country, the way fairness seems to be executed or was executed in South Korea. I mean, we lived over there, and you and I both feel very happy for there's a lot of happy people that are just living over there and experiencing some sort of hopefulness. And we don't have hopefulness right now overall. There are some people who are happy Trump is in, but overall, we are not. And if he were to follow all the laws that are in place, that would be one thing, but he's not following all the laws. And I would like to see an impeachment process happen if, in fact, it's proven that he's broken the laws. For example, one of the laws he's not following is you are not allowed to financially benefit from private industry at all as a public servant. He's a public servant who has so many different businesses, and they've advertised in the White House his businesses. I mean, he's flying to that private residence on the government ticket, on taxpayers' money, down to Florida every weekend almost, and he's doing so many things that he shouldn't be doing by law. You know, whether you agree or disagree with this policy, it's like he's breaking the law, and it's happening right before our very eyes. I feel like there's no way we would ever be able to do what South Korea did. I just wanna say that. Well, because the world is watching, and you can tell that the world more and more is making fun of Trump because it's just so ridiculous what's happening, that he's completely taking advantage of the system. And she took advantage of the system over there, and guess what? She got caught, and the will of the people succeeded. And is the will of the people going to succeed in every case? I feel like the United States is too big of a country geographically and with population in terms of South Korea being small. Like, that's why they were really able to do this.
So what does this mean for the future of South Korea? Well, there is going to be a new election coming up. They're calling it the Cherry Blossom election. There's a deadline for May 9th which will be the final day that they can have this election.
They have to do the election within 60 days of the impeachment.
Yes, which gives them about 37 days to get final candidates and about 23 days to campaign, which I personally think is fantastic.
It should be that way, that's right.
The big long campaign process. The current forerunners for this is the current prime minister and acting president, Hwang Kyo-an, who would actually have to resign his position in order to run. He's got a long, extensive history as a prosecutor and a federal justice minister. He's also the current prime minister. And his stance, so you know, is he's very tough on North Korea, and he's pro-THAAD, which is the missile defense system. So he is the conservative possible candidate. Yeah, exactly, because China hates that. The other possibility that is the other probable president who has the most favor of the people right now is the former head of the Democratic Party, Moon Jae-in, who almost won the presidency in 2012. He was a human rights lawyer.
He was also one of the former president Noh Moo-hyun's advisors?
Campaign manager and chief of staff.
Okay.
And his values are very similar to that former president. And other things that he wants to do is repeal security laws used to oppose the left wing and abolish the NIS, which is the National Intelligence Service, which takes domestic information and uses it to maintain political neutrality. So he is for free speech, and he is the liberal candidate, if you will.
It's going to be very, very interesting and exciting and definitely hopeful in the near future for South Korea, whatever happens. Please, you guys, comment down below in the comment section. Let us know what you think. How closely have you been following the scandal that was Park Geun-hye, that is Park Geun-hye, that's sort of come to some conclusion?
Did you see, like, the thing that's going viral right now about this, though? It has nothing to do with Park Geun-hye. It's the guy who was being interviewed by the BBC and his kids came in behind them. And what I'm assuming is his wife, like, pulled his kids out into the hallway. And everybody's going viral. Like, I'm seeing it all over my news feeds.
Why is it important?
Because people can relate to it. But that's what's going viral and not the fact that Park Geun-hye got impeached.
They're gonna make a movie. They can make multiple movies.
Oh, they definitely should.
They're gonna do both, movies and dramas. Comment, you guys, click the like button. Thank you so much for supporting us. Click the bell for notifications. Check out the link to Kgal, and don't forget to subscribe for more Hallyu Back news. That's it, we're out of here. Hasta luego.
Bye.